He's swapping the campaign trail for center stage last night, trading jokes at the Alfred E. Smith charity dinner benefiting Catholic Charities, but thinks they may got a little personal right now. Listen.
And I got the chance to meet the people who are working so hard to get her elected. The heads of NBC, CNN, CBS, ABC. There's the New York Times right over there and the Washington Post. They're working overtime.
It's amazing I'm up here after Donald. I didn't think he'd be okay with a peaceful transition of power.
All right, joining us now is Al E. Smith V. The dinner is named after his great-great-grandfather, and he attended last night's event, sitting right in front of the dais. Al, thanks so much for being with us. Your great-great-grandfather, Al Smith, was known as the Happy Warrior. People were saying that last night it was a little less happy and a little more warrior than perhaps we're used to seeing from the speakers there. Do you think that any of the speeches, Hillary Clinton's or Donald Trump's, that crossed the line?
You know, before we get into any of the politics of the dinner last night, I just want to say how proud I am of my father, Alfred E. Smith IV, and the foundation, the Alfred E. Smith Memorial Foundation, in conjunction with Cardinal Dolan, and the fact that they were able to take the energy from this campaign, and even some of the acrimony, actually, and point it into a positive direction to raise money for some of the neediest children in New York City is just remarkable. And you know, no matter what you have to say about either candidate, something good did come from the dinner as well as this campaign.
No question.
Even at the very end.
It raised more than $6 million, record-setting, I believe. And it is important. And both candidates made a point of saying how important it was to raise the money for the Catholic Charities there. That's a great thing. But we are here this morning with a lot of people saying like they hadn't been to an Al Smith dinner quite like the one last night.
True. I've been to a lot of the dinners in my life, and this was one for the record books, I would have to say, absolutely.
What do you think did cross the line?
Well, I think, you know, what we saw a lot in the last debate a couple nights ago, we saw last night. You know, Donald had some very solid minutes in the early on, and eventually he crossed the line and took it a little too far. Hillary, you know, on the other hand, was able to laugh at herself and at the same time not underplay any of the serious things that Donald Trump has said or done.
You know, it's interesting. You talked about Hillary Clinton. One of your favorite moments last night was when Hillary Clinton, in a way, made a joke about herself and Donald Trump and the debate all at the same time. Let's listen.
Because this is a friendly dinner for such a great cause, Donald, if at any time you don't like what I'm saying, feel free to stand up and shout wrong while I'm talking.
You like that. It was nice to see them both smile right there.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Go ahead.
That wrong was something that we heard so many times in those three debates, and that was pretty funny last night.
Your favorite moment for Donald Trump was when you made a joke about his wife, Melania. We played that a short time ago, but when you were talking about maybe Donald Trump after starting out strong, and the Melania joke was flat out hilarious, everyone thought so, crossing the line may have been where he made a joke about what Hillary Clinton's campaign staff was emailing about Catholics. Listen to this.
Hillary believes that it's vital to deceive the people by having one public policy and a totally different policy in private. That's okay. I don't know who they're angry at, Hillary. You're right. For example, here she is tonight in public pretending not to hate Catholics.
There were boos there. You saw Hillary Clinton glance over to the side there. What was it like in the room when he told that joke?
That's a tough crowd to drop that line in front of, to be honest with you. That certainly took the tone in a different direction. And, you know, I think ultimately at the end of the day, that made things a lot harder for Hillary. When ultimately she got the mic, she had some very funny things that she had said. And I don't think they got as many laughs as they could have just because the tone in the room had shifted a bit.
Do you think, I mean, were people left uncomfortable after that? Because I had that sense watching on TV that after that moment from Donald Trump, people weren't laughing quite as hard. Some of the joy was kind of gone.
The room did get a little uncomfortable. Yeah, like I said, you know, that line in a room full of predominantly Catholics, that didn't go over very well.
So you were sitting sort of on the floor near the dais looking up at all the people sitting there. There were comments, you know, would they shake hands? Ultimately, they did shake hands afterwards. People were watching the body language very, very closely. If you could grade sort of the physical comfort level between the candidates, Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, with Cardinal Dolan sitting in between them,
yep,
over the course of the night, you know, one being extremely comfortable, 10 being, you know, extremely uncomfortable, what grade would you give it?
I would say it changed throughout the night. I would say in the beginning it was pretty friendly. I would say more on a 6 or a 7. I did see them shake hands, I think, before most did. I think the camera may have actually even panned. But Cardinal Dolan did a great job of bringing them together, and certainly my dad's humor right out of the gates, you know, leveled the playing field and you know, made it a nice, warm presence to start. My dad took control very early on and lightened the room.
He was great. Your father was terrific there, Cardinal Dolan as well. And, you know, hats off to both the candidates for trying to make people laugh. I know it can be hard. Al Smith, great to have you with us, and congratulations on the record set.